Welcome to Shika. I'm Dr. Shinichiro Yano, and this is Dr. Kirill Low. This is Shika, a cold tube active spectrometer. This is a collaboration between Taiwanese and Australian. This is for inelastic neutron scattering experiment.
So inelastic scattering is looking at how atoms might vibrate due to thermal influences. So we're standing here at room temperature, and all the atoms around us have got enough energy that they're oscillating and vibrating. And so we call these oscillations and vibrations phonons, and they tell us a little bit about how we might transmit information through a material, either sound or heat through a material, and this can tell us a lot about the properties of materials. We can also measure with Seeker the magnetic oscillations called magnons or spinons. So we have little magnets here, and what's happening in our magnetic materials is our little magnetic moments or magnetic spins oscillate. Yeah. And this can tell us about the magnetic properties and how the lattice and the magnetism are coupled in the system, and can tell us a lot about superconducting materials, high temperature superconductors, multiferroics, and also about low dimensional magnetic materials.
So this is a triple axis spectrometer. We have three axes, and we are very close to the reactor, the big reactor. And from reactor we get neutron, and the first axis is the monochromator. We get monochromator with monochromate beam, which we choose energy. That neutron coming through the sample. On the sample, we have many sample environment. We can cool down sample. We have applied magnetic field and also even applied pressure. So we have a sample here. We are cooling very much down to minus 270 degrees. And then and also we are protected with aluminum, which aluminum is very transparent to the neutron. And then after the sample, the neutron goes to analyzer. We protect it very much, and the analyzer with big chunk of polyethylene. And this is the analyzer, the third axis.
So the monochromator will choose a particular energy that it's going to direct at the sample. The sample, the neutron will then interact with the sample and scatter towards the analyzer. And the analyzer chooses the energy that it directs to the detector. So if the monochromator and the analyzer are choosing different energies, then what we observe in our detector is an inelastic event. Because it's a cold neutron spectrometer, we do a lot of low energy investigations, up to a few millielectron volts. And we can investigate materials similar to this beautiful sample that I have here. So this beautiful sample I have here is actually a crystal, a naturally made crystal of azurite. Now, azurite is a material that we've known since ancient times. It's been used as a blue pigment in paint in ancient Egypt. But what's really curious about this material is it's kind of a cool quantum magnet. So in this material, the copper magnetic moments, which are responsible for the blue color, the copper magnetic moments form diamond-like chains in the material. And these chains are isolated from each other. So the interactions occur only within the chain. So we started looking at this material to try and understand a little bit more about one-dimensional magnetic interactions. But what we discovered is that when we changed the temperature and when we applied high magnetic fields up to 15 tesla, we were able to induce some pretty exotic magnetic states. And this told us that the interactions in this material were a lot more complicated than we originally thought. And so with this material, we were able to develop some mathematical models to try and understand magnetic interactions, and in particular, the competing interactions in this material called azurite, which you might still find in your blue paint at home. So Shin and I both do most of our research looking at magnetic materials. The quantum magnetism is really defined by the fundamental properties of the electron. So the electron contains an intrinsic property called magnetic spin. So that's a little bit like a little tiny bar magnet on our electron, and that is what's responsible for the magnetic properties of the materials we investigate. And so when we apply a magnetic field, it's like we're manipulating the magnetic spin on our sample. And so this is exactly what we do to try and understand the magnetic properties of our materials. So Seeker is a really wonderful instrument, cold neutron spectrometer. It combines a real international collaboration, and it's one of the most highly configurable and versatile instruments at ANSTO.